Hi everyone, it's Roseanne. I am bringing you my design team project for elegant embellishments. And I did a multimedia or mixed media canvas. And the picture that you see before you is the picture of myself and my daughters. And this picture was taken about 5 years ago, maybe 10 years ago actually, now that I think about it. It's been quite a while. And before I get started, I'll go ahead and I'll show you the laces that I used and the embellishments. First of all, I'll show you the metals that I used. And I used the corner piece here, which is right there. And I'll get a give you a close-up here shortly. I also used the flower, and that is actually right there. I used the buckle, and that is right there. I used the penny farthing, and that, of course, is right there. I use the little charms that I have had for quite some time. Dee had this in her store prior to now, and that is located actually right there. And then I have the resin heart, and that is right there above the right there, above the little dice. I also used lace trim, the white, actually, lace number 6, oops, and that's located throughout in different places, and I actually will show you that. I used one of Dee's favorites and one of my favorites, and this one is CL002. And that one is located down here. I use the Miranda 2, and that's lace number 7. And that actually is down up here. I used a little tiny snippet of the trim number 7. This is my favorite black lace. And this is actually located up here. And then I used lace number 4. And this is the heart one, and it is located over here. So let me go ahead and do a close-up here now of all of the areas. And that way I can show you what I did. So starting on the upper area here in the right corner, I first started by using the Kirby Teasdale paper line that we all get from Hobby Lobby, and I'm going to back out here. And I've also used the cording that my sissy Janet gave me. Thank you, Janet. Okay, in the first layer, what I did was, of course, I used the Kirby Teasdale paper, and I kind of wanted to have the pattern come through. By the time I was done, it all got covered up. So I also laid a piece of curtain, which is what you see this texture here, down with a layer of Mod Podge. I then added the Miranda 2 lace. You can see it in there. And then this die cut area here, this die cut from, you know, my die cuts out of chipboard. This is just a little metal flower that I've had forever and a bead cap. And then this is the little bits of flower that I used throughout as an embellishment, which is that flower there. These are some resin hearts, just some buttons. This is some bling. And that's a bottle cap with bead caps and just a bunch of... This is a tiny little cherub. This actually is a little bead that was on like a lanyard for your phones, your cell phones. A button, another resin piece, got some wire, leftover wire from your flowers, you know, that we cut off. Coiled it there, and this is some scrunched up paper with a paper rose. And there again, you can see that little flower. Here is that black lace, which is lace number 7. It's a little bit there, just a tiny bit here. The penny farthing is there with the acrylic flower over it. This is a paper flower. This is my scroll and some beaded trim. It's a resin flower. That's some beaded trim here. And there's that flower again. And that's the entire piece of lace there without me cutting it. There's a resin flower and some beads, some paper flowers, a paper tag. This was a piece of acrylic. And on top of that, there is a rub-on. There's a little flower button that my friend Julie gave me. And there's a piece of beaded trim there. And then there's a little charm, lock charm back there. More buttons. This is a connector from Radio Shack or something. These are beads. This is a chipboard heart, tiny little chipboard heart. More flat backs, roses, and there is that buckle slider. More buttons, flowers. That's a back of an earring, and there's that beautiful heart lace there. There is the resin flower. There. And a domino. There's a little pin and a fuse. And then I had this one flower just laying on my desk with a little vine, so I stuck that there. And I had also some seed beads on a wire, and I coiled them up and stuck them there. This is a bottle cap with just another flower, some more beads, some bling, some pearls. There's some more bling here. Paperclip. This is a washer with just some more bits of beaded trim, and this is a little rose, metal rose that Marlene gave me for you, Marlene. There's a button, there's the little key charm, Monopoly House, that's a halfback pearl, that's a little butterfly bead spacer, I guess you would call it, and a button. Resin flower. There's some trim from my stash there. This faucet was given to me by For You Marlene 1. There's a screw. There's a domino with a little tiny bead cap and some more flat back elements. That's a button. Right along here is this lace. Oops, this lace, which I have it upside down. There you go. There it is. You can barely see it. And then I also used the metal flower there from the metal flower kit. There's that little flower again that I cut out, and that's the corner, the metal corner. This is a piece of beach glass and a little resin bow, a resin cameo from my stash, some more scrunched up paper. Another button and a tiny little heart button, a key from For You Marlene, and a dice there. And then once I sprayed it all, I gessoed it in the white areas there so that it looks like the light is coming this way. And excuse me, this lighting is really, really bad. It's more red, purple, and black, and I don't know that you'll be able to see those colors coming through on the video. It doesn't look like it is on the video. I then put some rub-ons here. There's a tiny bit of rub-on there which got covered up. There's some on there that got covered up. There's a little bit there. There's a little bit there. There's the rub-on there. There was some here. And I think those are the only areas that I put rub-ons. There's this rub-on here. And I may go back and just put some more, maybe a thicker rub-on down here, so that it shows up, because it really, in this light, you really can't see them. This is a rub-on that says Mischief. It got hidden though. But that is my design team project for Dee's Elegant Embellishments. And I want to thank you all for coming by. This was a lot of fun. I definitely will do another one. It didn't take me too long. It just took me like one afternoon. Most of the time took drying everything. But I will have the links to Dee's store and her channel and all the other designers in the description. And don't forget to visit the other designers and see what they're all coming up with. Thank you so much for visiting my channel and leaving your lovely comments. Welcome to all my new subbies. And I think that's it. Stay tuned for more projects, and God bless everyone.